Christmas to know, that we may share the gifts we are given. Para construir la comunidad. Para construir la comunidad. In the living water, we have become one body in the Lord. Oh, love of God, gather us. Amor de Dios, haznos uno. Share the gifts we are given para construir la comunidad. Para construir la comunidad. A diversos dones, pero un solo Dios que nos inspira. Oh, love of God, gather us. Amor de Dios, haznos uno. That we may share the gifts we are given. Para construir la comunidad. Para construir la comunidad. Together to do the works of love. Oh, love of God, gather us. Amor de Dios, haznos uno. That we may share the gifts we are given. Para construir la comunidad. Para construir la comunidad.
Good evening, friends. And welcome to the Mass of Lord's Last Supper. Let's begin the Mass. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Brothers and sisters, every year the bishop blesses oils for use throughout the church. We now receive these oils with gratitude for the healing and life-giving grace we receive by means of them.
The oil of the sick.
May the sick who are anointed with this oil experience the compassion of Christ and his saving love in body and soul. Your response will be, blessed be God forever.
Blessed be God forever.
The oil of the catechumens.
Through anointing with this oil, may our catechumens who are preparing to receive the saving waters of baptism be strengthened by Christ to resist the power of Satan and reject evil in all its forms.
Blessed be God forever.
The Holy Chrism.
Through anointing with this perfumed chrism, may children and adults who are baptized and confirmed, and priests who are ordained, experience the gracious gift of the Holy Spirit.
Blessed be God forever.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We bless you, we adore you, we glorify you.
take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High Jesus Christ. With the Holy Spirit in the glory of God the Father.
Let us pray. O God, who have called us to participate in this most sacred supper, in which your only begotten Son, when about to hand himself over to death, entrusted to the church a sacrifice new for all eternity, the banquet of his love, grant, we pray, that we may draw from so great a mystery the fullness of charity and of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month shall stand at the head of your calendar. You shall reckon it the first month of the year. Tell the whole community of Israel, on the 10th of this month, every one of your families must procure for itself a lamb, one apiece for each household. If a family is too small for a whole lamb, it shall join the nearest household in procuring one and shall share in the lamb in the proportion of the number of persons who partake of it. The lamb must be a year old male without blemish. You may take it from either the sheep or the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of this month. And then, with the whole assembly of Israel present, it shall be slaughtered during the evening twilight. They shall take some of its blood and apply it to the two doorposts and the lintel of every house in which they partake of the lamb. That same night, they shall eat its roasted flesh with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. This is how you are to eat it: with your loins girt, sandals on your feet, and your staff in hand, you shall eat it like those who are in flight. It is the Passover of the Lord. For on this same night, I will go through Egypt, striking down every firstborn of the land, both man and beast, and executing judgment on all the gods of Egypt. I, the Lord. But the blood will mark the house where you are. Seeing the blood, I will pass over you. Thus, when I strike the land of Egypt, no destructive blow will come upon you. This day shall be a memorial feast for you, which all generations shall celebrate with pilgrimage to the Lord as a perpetual institution." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
cup is our communion with the blood of Christ. Our blessing cup is our communion with the blood of Christ. How shall I make our return to the Lord for all the good that he has done for me? The cup of salvation I will take up, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. Our blessing cup is our communion with the blood of Christ. Precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death of his faithful ones. I am your servant, the son of your handmaid. You have loosed my bonds. Our blessing cup is our communion with the blood of Christ. Sacrifice of thanksgiving, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. My vows to the Lord I will pay in the presence of all his people. Our blessing cup is our communion with the blood of Christ.
Lectura de la primera carta del apóstol San Pablo a los Corintios. Hermanos, yo recibí del Señor lo mismo que les he transmitido, que el Señor Jesús, la noche en que iba a ser entregado, tomó pan en sus manos y pronunciando la acción de gracias, lo partió y dijo, esto es mi cuerpo que se entrega por ustedes. Hagan esto en memoria mía. Lo mismo hizo con el cáliz después de cenar, diciendo, este cáliz es la nueva alianza que se sella con mi sangre. Hagan esto en memoria mía siempre que beban de él. Por eso, cada vez que ustedes comen de este pan y beben de este cáliz, proclaman la muerte del Señor hasta que vuelva. Palabra de Dios.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Lord. Before the feast of Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to pass from this world to the Father. He loved his own in the world, and he loved them to the end. The devil had already induced Judas, son of Simon of Iscariot, to hand him over. So during supper, fully aware that the Father had put everything into his power, that he had come from God and was returning to God, he rose from supper and took off his outer garments. He took a towel and tied it around his waist, and he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and dry them with the towel around his waist. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Master, are you going to wash my feet?" And Jesus answered and said to him, "What I am doing you do not understand now, but you will understand later." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." And Jesus answered him, "Unless I wash you, you will have no inheritance with me." And Simon Peter said to him, "Master, then not only my feet, but my hands and my head as well." Jesus said to him, "Whoever has bathed has no need except to have his feet washed, for he is clean all over. So you are clean, but not all." For he knew who would betray him. For this reason he said, "Not all of you are clean." So when he had washed their feet and put his garments back on and reclined at table again, he said to them, "Do you realize what I have done for you? You call me teacher and master, and rightly so, for indeed I am. If I, therefore, master and teacher, have washed your feet, you ought to wash one another's feet. I have given you a model to follow, so that as I have done for you, you should also do." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Well, good evening again. Tonight, we have gathered here in this sacred place to celebrate the Passover meal, the Passover meal of our Lord Jesus Christ. The first reading, we are told that this will be a meal, a perpetual meal for all eternity. That's what God commanded his people to celebrate. But in the New Testament, our Lord Jesus Christ establishes a sacred meal, the Passover meal, and he commands us to celebrate that for all eternity. There is a big difference, the Old Testament Passover meal and the New Testament Passover meal. In the Old Testament Passover, it was a lamb, an unblemished lamb that was slaughtered, and the people were supposed to eat the lamb. In the New Testament Passover, it's a Lamb of God himself who is offering us himself as the food for us to consume, to eat and be nourished. He becomes the food for us. So today we remember that Last Supper our Lord celebrated, where he instituted the most important sacrament of the church, and that is, what's the most important sacrament of the church? The Eucharist, the life-giving sacrament of the church, the sacrament that sustains the life of the church, sustains the life of his God's people, is the Holy Eucharist. And that's what he instituted today at the Last Supper. Vatican II tells us the Eucharist is the source and summit of our life. It's the beginning and the end. As God says, he is the Alpha and the Omega for us, Catholics, the Eucharist is everything. Without the Eucharist, our souls starve. With the Eucharist, we are constantly nourished with the life of God. And where do we find the real source in the Bible where we can say, yes, Eucharist is really the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ? Because Catholics believe that in the Eucharist, the Lord is truly and substantially present. He is physically present, body and soul, body and blood, soul and divinity. The Lord is fully, wholly present there. But not every Christian believes that. But for us, we can go back to the scripture, John, the Gospel of John chapter 6, that tells us about the bread of life discourse. The Lord clearly tells us, especially in verse 55, he says, my flesh is real food. My blood is real drink. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood will have life eternal. What's the Lord giving us here? He's giving us his flesh to eat, his blood to drink, and by eating his flesh and drinking his blood, we will have life, life eternal. The greatest gift that we can imagine is the gift of eternal life. And God is giving us through his Son's body and blood. And that's what we celebrate every time we gather here. As he instituted this most important sacrament of the church, the Holy Eucharist, he said, do this in memory of me. Whenever, wherever you gather together, do this in memory of me. But who is going to do this? Who is going to keep this sacrifice for all eternity? Well, he institutes the sacrament of Holy Priesthood. And that's why today is our Priesthood Day. Did you know Holy Thursday is Priesthood Day?
Yes.
You did not know? And you've been Catholic for so many years and you did not know Holy Thursday is Priesthood Day, that you are called to pray for your priest, thank God for your priest. If you haven't done that, yes, you do it every day, but not everybody. If you haven't done that today, especially today, pray for your priest, thank God for your priest. But today, on this Priesthood Day, I want to honor two priests here. One priest who has been celebrating these Easter liturgies for 61 years. And another priest who is about to celebrate the Easter liturgies for the first time as a priest. So we have a grandpa priest and a baby priest. Who is a priest? A priest is a human being like you, like anyone here sitting here. We are just like any of you. But a priest is a man chosen and called by God, set apart from his own people, to represent him. Priest is above all a man of God. That's his identity. Priest is a man of God who is called by God to lead his people to God. We may all look like very ordinary, and we are, but at the same time, priests are also extraordinary because they are men of God. They are set apart by God to lead God's people, to sanctify God's people, to lead them to eternal life, to bring the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, to transform the symbol bread and wine into the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ through the power of the Holy Spirit by saying the same words our Lord said at the Last Supper, whereby bread and wine became his body and blood. That very act is being done here through the priest. How many of us really recognize your priest as men of God, set apart by God? And when they speak God's words on behalf of God for God's people. John Mary Vianney, the patron saint of the priests, once said, "If I come across a priest and an angel, I would first greet the priest and bow before him before I greet the angel. The angel lives in the presence of God, but for me, the priest is God himself. He represents God. He's not actually God, but he is the image of God for God's people." So much so that John Mary Vianney said that he would honor the priest before he would even honor the angels. That's the dignity of a priest. The priest ministry is not an easy ministry, especially in today's world. And any time a young man says yes to God, he's saying yes to a life of sacrifice till he dies. A priest is ordained not for himself. A priest is ordained for God's people. We are here not for ourselves. We don't live for ourselves. We have been called by God to live for God's people. When you need to go to confession, you call a priest. When you need anointing, you call a priest. When you are sick, you want counseling, you want prayers, you call a priest. When someone passes in your family, you want hope and comfort, you call a priest. When your soul is thirsting and longing for God, you call a priest. You call a priest at all the important moments of your life, because you know priest brings God to you. And yet, we are sinful human beings chosen by God. Today on this day, Priesthood Day, I beg you, pray for your priest. Don't judge them always. We are human beings like you. We are not perfect. We are not angels. Though the priests have a higher dignity than the angels, yet we are not angels. We live in a body. And we are sinners like you, but striving and struggling every day to answer the call to live a holy life for the people of God. Today, lift us up to the Lord. Lift all the priests up to the Lord. Pray for them. Thank the Lord for your priests. Because if there is no priest, there is no Eucharist. And no Eucharist, no life of God for us. And so recognize and realize how important a priest is in your life. Thank God for them. Amen?
Amen.
Wait. They're in a hurry, but that's okay.
Para nosotros es una oportunidad para nosotros para glorificar a nuestro Señor. Nuestro Señor le dijo, ustedes me llaman maestro y señor. Ustedes me llaman maestro y señor porque confías en mí. Porque sabías que yo lo quiero estar allí contigo Yo lo voy a sacrificar por ti. Yo lo voy a estar con ti. Y nuestro Señor quería que nosotros nos siguiera a Él. En el Antiguo Testamento, cuando Abraham, por llamada de Dios, quería sacrificar a su hijo se llevó todo lo que necesita por el sacrificio y le pidió a su padre: Padre, ¿dónde está el árbol? ¿Dónde está el cordero? Por el sacrificio. Y el padre Abraham le dijo: Nuestro Señor lo va a proveer el animal por el sacrificio. Y cuando está allí, cuando está creciendo ese altar para tener un sacrificio, se pidió otra vez: Padre, ¿a dónde está el cordero por el sacrificio? Y el padre Abraham le dijo: Lo padre va a proveer. Pero cuando él está allí sobre ese altar, está pidiendo: ¿A dónde está el sacrificio? Y el padre Abraham le dijo: Tú eres el sacrificio. Pero por llamada de Dios le dijo: No, 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 no va a sacrificar a su hijo por mí. Yo lo voy a sacrificar a mi hijo para ti. Yo lo voy a dar todo lo que necesita. Y allí está un cordero. Y el padre lo sacrificó por Dios. Cuando estaba allí en el Éxodo, le dijo: Tome uno de los corderos, mátenlo, cocínalo, y también ponedlo sangre sobre su puerta. Y por ese día de Pascua, yo lo voy a estar allí sobre todo el Egipto, pero yo lo voy a pasar de su casa. Y por esa acción de gracia, por esa acción para estar siguiendo el mandamiento de Dios, se salvó. Porque nuestro Señor quería que nosotros nos podamos estar allí con Él, para seguir su ley, para seguir sus mandamientos, para también para seguir a su voz. Y por nosotros, para nosotros, nuestro Señor lo proveyó todo. Y en la noche, antes que nuestro Señor lo va a sufrir en su pasión, le dijo: Esto es mi cuerpo. Esto es mi sangre. Esta es la alianza del nuevo alianza. Hagan esto en conmemoración mía. Hagan esto en memoria mía cada vez. Y es una oportunidad para nosotros para mirar que nuestro Señor, cuando Él lo dio, cuando Él lo dio a su carne y a su sangre para nosotros, allí en el capítulo 6 de Juan, cuando Él está diciendo: Si no bebes la sangre de mí y no bebes a mi carne, no tenía vida entre su cuerpo. Y Él no está diciendo como un símbolo, pero Él está diciendo: Si no comes mi carne, si no comes mi cuerpo y no bebías a mi sangre, no tenía vida entre ustedes. Está comunicando la verdad, que el pan y el vino que Él tomó, y cuando Él le dijo sobre estas palabras: Esto es mi cuerpo y esto es mi sangre, se transformó por su cuerpo y su sangre. Y para nosotros, nuestro Señor comunicó el mismo misterio entre de nosotros, de cada uno de los sacerdotes que pidió que el Espíritu Santo santifiques esto mismo pan y esto mismo cáliz para transformar entre el cuerpo, sangre, alma y divinidad de nuestro Señor. Se transformó para que nosotros nos podamos nutrir a nuestras almas, para que nosotros nos podamos comer el mismo cuerpo y sangre de nuestro Señor que Él lo dio antes de sus discípulos allí en el Evangelio. Para expresar y para comunicar y también para comer. para tener nuestro Señor dentro de nuestras vidas, dentro de nuestros cuerpos, para sacrificar para nosotros, pero también para nutrir a nuestras almas, para crecer estos momentos de fe, de alabanza y de gloria, para dar la más profunda gracia que Él lo puede dar a nosotros, la gracia, la misericordia, pero también los sacramentos. Y los sacramentos que Él comunicó, los sacramentos que Él lo dio a la iglesia, es por los sacerdotes que están allí, en el mismo salón de Él. Los apóstoles y los discípulos que están allí, allí en la cena, la final cena de nuestro Señor. Cuando Él está expresando, comunicando y también está dando este misterio a ellos. Es en esta noche que creció el ministerio sacerdotal para comunicar esta gracia por la iglesia por eternidad. Y cuando durante la ordenación de cada sacerdote, de cada obispo, cuando Él lo pone las manos sobre la cabeza y cuando Él, con las palabras de nuestro Señor, en la ordenación de los sacerdotes, se comunica una gracia para que ellos se puedan estar en persona Christi Capitas. En persona Christi Capitas, para que cuando ellos celebran a los misterios de la iglesia, ellos están allí mismo como Cristo, para comunicar esta misma gracia, este mismo misterio para nosotros, para que nosotros nos podamos recibir esta gracia, para que nosotros nos podamos recibir a nuestro Señor, para que nosotros nos podamos recibir esta gracia por la santificación de nuestras almas, por la gracia de la vida eterna, y también para que nosotros nos podamos continuar en este viaje de fe. Para nosotros nos va a entrar en el sagrado triduo de nuestra iglesia. En este día nos celebramos la fiesta de la Día de Acciones de Gracia por nuestro Señor, para que Él lo dio a nosotros la Eucaristía. Mañana lo va a celebrar la pasión de nuestro Señor, que en esta pasión es una acción de victoria, porque nuestro Señor conquistó la muerte y los pecados. Se destruyó todo para que nosotros podamos estar allí con Él por los siglos de los siglos. Es una gracia que nuestro Señor quería comunicar, y solo lo puede comunicarlos por los sacerdotes y también por los obispos. En este misterio del sacerdote, en este misterio de cura de nuestras almas, los curas tenían una dignidad que es un poco diferente, porque nos podemos estar en persona de Cristo para comunicar esta gracia. Pero para todos nosotros que fue bautizados, tenemos el mismo misterio, que somos hijos e hijas de Dios. Somos hijos e hijas de Dios que quería que nos podamos recibir el mismo gracia, el mismo misterio, el mismo dignidad, porque somos hijos e hijas de Dios. Pero para los sacerdotes nos podemos estar en persona de Cristo para comunicar la gracia de los sacramentos, para comunicar la vida eterna, para perdonar a las almas de los pecados y también para profundizar la gloria y la alabanza de nuestro Señor aquí en el mundo. Para nosotros es una oportunidad para estar con nuestro Dios, para mirar a Él, cuerpo, sangre, alma y divinidad que está allí en la Eucaristía, para recibirlo con dignidad, para recibir con dignidad, para estar allí en nuestras almas que está listo para admitir Dios en nuestros cuerpos, para recibir Él que quería a nosotros antes todo el mundo, que nos podemos recibir el Señor y Maestro. En el Evangelio Él le dijo, ustedes me llamen Maestro y Señor. Y cuando nos comunican, nos recibimos nuestro Señor. Nos podemos decir, Señor y Maestro, dame lo que necesita para seguirte aquí en esta misión de salvación. Señor, dame lo que necesita aquí en este momento para seguirle. Señor, dame lo que necesita por mi salvación.
Next we'll be having the washing of the feet as our Lord washed the feet of his disciples at Last Supper. We'll be doing that in commemoration of what the Lord did. So. Thomas, put a little more inside. Those who have been chosen to have their feet washed, please come up. Yeah, push the chair inside a little more.
Thank you.
I have loved you. Here to wash each other's feet as I have done for you.
Please rise. Prayers of the faithful. Our vocation as Christian servants includes praying for one another. Tonight we remember those who suffer physical or psychological pain, as well as those who thirst for justice and peace.
That the Church's celebration at the table of the Eucharist will provide nourishment for the work of building the reign of God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Por los gobiernos y líderes mundiales, para que el mensaje de paz y bendición del Evangelio informe y dirija sus decisiones y acciones, roguemos al Señor.
That throughout these holy days, our parish community and those to be baptized may be fully immersed in the mystery of the Passover. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Por todos los que están enfermos, para que conozcan la curación y la transformación, roguemos al Señor.
For those who have died in the light of faith, may the mercy of our loving God usher them into the fullness of eternal life. We pray to the Lord.
Por las intenciones en la intimidad de nuestros corazones, por aquellas peticiones asentadas en nuestro libro memorial, y por todas las personas a las que les prometemos orar, roguemos al Señor.
And we lift up all our prayers to our Heavenly Father through the intercessions of our Blessed Mother as we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and in the hour of our death. Amen.
Oh, nuestros corazones, guíanos con tu luz, embriaga nuestro rostro, alumbranos con tu luz. Para aquel que cree en Cristo, Cristo a luz del mundo, tiene vida eterna y la luz de la vida. Brille tu luz en medio de las tinieblas, brille tu luz en nuestros corazones, guíanos con tu luz, embriaga nuestro rostro, alúmbranos con tu luz.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries, for whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the true and eternal priest who instituted the pattern of an everlasting sacrifice and was the first to offer himself as the saving victim, commanding us to make this offering as his memorial. As we eat his flesh that was sacrificed for us, we are made strong. And as we drink his blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus. Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, pleni sunt caeli et terra, gloria tua, hosanna in excelsis, benedictus, qui venit in nomine Domini, hosanna in excelsis.
To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, Kevin, our Bishop, Timothy and Thomas, his assistant bishops, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith.
Acuérdate, Señor, de tus hijos. de todos los aquí reunidos, cuya fe y entrega bien conoces, por ellos y todos los suyos, por el perdón de sus pecados y la salvación que esperan, te ofrecemos y ellos mismos te ofrecen este sacrificio de alabanza a ti, eterno Dios, vivo y verdadero. Reunidos en comunión con toda la Iglesia para celebrar el día santo en que nuestro Señor Jesucristo fue entregado por nosotros, veneramos la memoria ante todos de la gloriosa siempre Virgen María, Madre de Jesucristo, nuestro Dios y Señor, la de su esposo San José, la de los santos apóstoles y mártires, Pedro y Pablo, Andrés, Santiago y Juan, Tomás, Santiago, Felipe, Bartolomé, Mateo, Simón y Tadeo, Lino, Clito, Clemente y Sixto, Cornelio, Cipriano, Lorenzo, Crisógono, Juan y Pablo, Cosme y Damián, y la de todos los santos, por sus méritos y oraciones, concédenos en todo tu protección.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you as we observe the day on which our Lord Jesus Christ handed on the mysteries of his body and blood for his disciples to celebrate. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect, make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, for our salvation and the salvation of all, that is today, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servant, who have gone before us with the sigh of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ a place of refreshment, light, and peace, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. To us also, your servants, who though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant full share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints, admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace be with you. Peace be with you, Marcus. Peace be with you, Jimmy. Peace be with you, Deacon. Peace be with you, Ben.
On you stay with holy speccata mundi, miserere nobis. On you stay. Miserere nobis.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Seen as bread and wine.
es amor. Puede servir porque Dios es amor.
Let us pray. Grand Almighty God, that just as we are renewed by the supper of your Son in this present age, so we may enjoy his banquet for all eternity, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Now the Blessed Sacrament will be solemnly taken to the altar of repose. As we know, after the Last Supper, our Lord was betrayed, and he goes to pray. And so now we are also joining the Lord in time of prayer. We can all go to the hall, but we'll go in procession in order. Our choir, part of our choir will be leading us, and then our ushers are there to guide you. But I request you all to go to the hall, and we will be bringing the Lord at the end of the procession to the hall. And we will pray there and spend time with the Lord in prayer. But those of you who want to go back home, feel that they don't have the time to spend with the Lord sometime, you may. And I'll be watching for those. You can go home, but the rest, please observe prayerful silence as we process with the Lord to the altar of repose. Thank you.
Nobis.